integrate this integral 1 upon x x to the power n plus 1, we can take x to the power n common. There are various methods to integrate this, but if we take x to the power n common from denominator, it can be written like this: 1 plus 1 upon x to the power n in denominator. You can see is equal to 1 upon x to the power n plus 1 into 1 plus 1 upon x to the power n. Now we shall substitute t is equal to 1 plus 1 upon x to the power n, because its derivative is lying nearby. Now on differentiating this, 1 plus 1 upon x to the power n, you can see that it can be written like this: 1 plus x to the power minus n. So dt by dx will be derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of x to the power minus n minus n x to the power minus n minus 1, which we can write as minus n upon x to the power n plus 1. If we transfer x to the power minus n minus 1 in denominator, it can be written like this. Which implies dt upon minus n, transferring minus n on left hand side, and dx on right hand side. Dx upon x to the power n plus 1. Sorry, dx would be here in the integral. I missed. Dx upon x to the power n plus 1, you can see. Dx upon x to the power n plus 1. Both are dx upon x to the power n plus 1. Therefore, dx upon x to the power n plus 1 can be replaced by dt upon minus n. So the integral I will be dt upon minus n, value of dx upon x to the power n plus 1. And in denominator, 1 plus 1 upon x to the power n is there, which we have substituted as t. So it is t. Now, again, as I used to say, that numerator is complete because numerator is having something in denominator, but denominator is incomplete because it doesn't have anything in denominator. So it can be written like t by 1 by introducing 1 in denominator of denominator. So this we can write as dt upon minus n into t. 1 upon minus n can be taken common. 1 by t, integral of 1 by t will be log of mod of t. Log of mod of t, base e plus an integral constant c. Now on substituting value of t, log of mod of 1 plus 1 upon x to the power n plus an integral constant c. If we wish to simplify, we can simplify it more. Simplification is important for objective questions, because in objective questions, sometimes answer may not be of our choice. So this can be written like this. And as I told you, that there is an important property, minus log of p, you can write as log of 1 upon p for any base. This is a very important property. So if we introduce this minus inside of this log, then it can be written like 1 upon n log of x to the power n upon x to the power n plus 1 with modulus base e plus integral constant c. So finally, this is the integral of the given integral 1 upon x to the power n plus 1. In the same way, you may integrate two more integrals, like 1 upon x वन माइनस एक्स टू द पावर एम बाय टेकिंग एक्स टू द पावर एम कॉमन. अनदर इंटीग्रल वन अपॉन
सर
एक्स एक्स टू द पावर सिक्स प्लस टू डीएक्स. हाँ बोलो बेटा.
सर वो जो आपने लिखा है देयरफॉर इंटीग्रल इज इक्वल्स टू इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ डीटी माइनस सर उसमें डीएक्स क्यों आएगा आपने
डीएक्स
देखो डीएक्स लिखा है
हाँ लिखा.
ना सर देयरफॉर जहां आपने देयरफॉर इंटीग्रल इज इक्वल्स टू
देयरफोर आई इज इक्वल टू
हाँ
डीएक्स कहाँ है वो दिख रहा होगा दूर से. डीएक्स
नहीं सर
डीटी है.
वो मतलब डी टी अपॉन माइनस एन अपॉन टी इज इक्वल्स टू इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ डी टी अपॉन माइनस एक्स टी अपॉन वन
ओ
डी एक्स
हाँ
लिखा आपने
हाँ ये डीएक्स है ठीक है.